know how to simplify these one variable expressions like this. We bring all the terms that have variables in them, the like terms, the 3x, the 7x, the minus 2x, we bring all those together. Right, this is 3x plus 7x minus 2x. And then we put the constants together over here, plus 4 minus 3. Now, notice we're very careful to keep track of our signs. Plus 3x plus 3x plus 7x plus 7x minus 2x minus 2x plus 4 minus 3. Keep your signs straight. Now that we've grouped all these x terms together, we can add them all up. 3x plus 7x is 10x. 10x minus 2x is 8x. And the reason we can do that is we can factor out the x and write it like this. That's why we can combine all these terms and write them as 3 plus 7 minus 2, which is 8 times x. And then, of course, 4 minus 3, that's just 1. So we know how to handle this with just one variable. What about two variables? How about three? Let's try that. Here we've got a bunch of variables. We've got three variables now instead of just one. But the game is the same. We're going to group the like terms. We're going to bring the 3a, the 3a, and the minus 4a. We're going to bring all of those together. And then we're going to do the same thing with the b terms. We're going to bring 2b together with the minus 3b. And then the 7 minus 7c is off here by itself. Again, we're very careful about our signs. Plus 3a, plus 3a, minus 4a. Plus 2b, plus 2b, minus 3b, minus 3b, minus 7c, minus 7c. And a little confused now. I want to make sure I got all the terms. So sometimes when I have a lot of terms like this, I'll just do a quick count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, got them all. I've got all the A's together. Got the B's together. And I've got the C over here by itself. Now these we can combine. 3A plus 3A is 6A. 6A minus 4A is 2A. 2B minus 3B, that gives us minus B. And then of course we have our minus 7C out there. And if you're looking at this and thinking, hey, this is nothing new, this is the same thing we did before, then you got it. There's really nothing new here. All we're doing is collecting like terms. It's like terms if the variable expressions are the same. A, collect all the A's. B, B, we collect the B's. C, we collect the C. Collect the like terms, simplify, and we're done. Let's try one more. Well, this one's only got two variables, but it's a little more complicated because we have terms here with the variables multiplied together. And they all have x and y, so it looks like we might just be able to combine everything together. But that's x squared times y, and that's just xy. That one doesn't have x squared, that one doesn't have x squared. So I'm going to start off, I'm just going to put these two together because they have x squared times y. Both of them, the variables are exactly the same. X squared times y. These are like terms. 3x squared y. And again, I'm careful about my signs. Plus 4x squared y. And then these two terms are like terms as well. It's x times y. It's not x squared times y. So these aren't like these terms. They are like each other. So I'm going to put those two together as well. 2xy over 5 minus 8xy. Over 5. Now these two we can combine just as if you'd add 3a and 4a and get 7a. Here we have 3x squared y and 4x squared y, we'll get 7x squared y. And the reason again we can do that is we can factor out the x squared times y with the distributive property. If I expanded this back, I'd get 3 times x squared y. I'd get 4 times x squared y, I'd get this right here. So I factored out the x squared times y, and of course that just simplifies down to 7x squared y. Now what about this over here? We can do the same thing. We can pull that xy out and write this as minus 2 fifths minus 8 fifths times xy. And if I multiplied this xy back in here, expanded this product, I'd get that right back. Minus 2 fifths times xy minus 8 fifths times xy. Now I can combine these, minus 2 fifths, minus 8 fifths, that's minus 10 fifths, otherwise known as minus 2. And once you get used to this, you'll skip this intermediate step. You might even skip this one, but you got to be really, really careful. And you'll just see, hey, 3x squared y, 4x squared y, 3 and 4 is 7. Minus 2/5 xy, minus 8/5 xy. Minus 2/5 and minus 8/5 is minus 2. And you'll probably write it like this. But here's where we have to stop. These aren't like terms. X squared y is different than xy. We have the same variables, but here the x is squared, and here it isn't. These aren't like terms. We can't write this as 5, which is 7 minus 2. We can't write this as 5 times something. We stop right here, and we are done.